Okay, today we're going to truss a chicken using a trussing needle. This one looks a bit like it's been run over, but wait till you see when it's finished. You'll see it all nice and neat. First thing I'm going to do is take out the wishbone. The wishbone, it stops us from carving the chicken later on. So I'm going to take the wishbone over and put it on its back. Remember, the legs are pointing away from where the wishbone is, so it's this end of the chicken. I'm going to cut through the skin and the back of the chicken. Maybe remove that little bit of extra neck that's there. Don't really want that in my chicken. I'm going to get rid of that. We'll just chop that off, out of the way. And then I'm going to take out the wishbone. And to take out the wishbone, I need to scrape down either side of the chicken. Like so. It's already broken in this one, so we'll be scraping either side. And then we're going to cut down the end of the chicken. Take out the wishbone, broken, but now the other side, and that's the wishbone. Then we're going to tidy the chicken up and get it ready for trussing. We're going to bring the legs of the chicken forward as far as we can. Just tuck those wings under first, makes it a little bit easier afterwards. We'll bring the legs forward as far as we can. The bone is running through here, so we're going to cut through the back of the bone, not through the breast of the chicken, through the body of the chicken and out the other side. So we're going to pull the chicken all the way through so we get to the end of the string. We're going to turn the chicken over and we're going to go through the wing. Just record up there. Go through the wing, like so. Pick up any bits of fat that might be, or the skin that's there that we just cut through. Pick that up so it looks all nice and neat. Yeah. And then through the other side of the other wing, so we've got the chicken and the meat's back up where we started from. So put the chicken up there. And then we're going to tie it. And when I tie it, we usually go 1, 2, 3, and that enables us the chicken not to slip back. They're not to slip back when we're tying it. So it makes it much easier to tie the knot so it doesn't slip back on you. Okay, cut that off. Chicken starts to look a bit nicer. And then we're going to use some more string. That should be off that. And we're going to go through just where the skin part is of the chicken, not through the breast, just where the skin part. Some people pick up the end of that bone, there's a little pliable bone there. We're just going to go through the end part. Chicken like so. All the way through, but obviously not pull it too far through. Pick up a little bit of this fatty part in the back, skin there, pull that through, and we should be then meeting up on the other side where we started from. Put the needle off. Okay, so that's one side, other side, and then we're going to do the same thing. Notice that I actually got the knots on the same side of the chicken. That makes it easier when you've roasted a lot of chickens, you can cut the same string on the same side with the knot. So pull that down tight again. Nice and tight, get that legs in, nice and firm. Keeps the chicken from roasting nicely. So, quite tight enough. Nice and firm. And then we're going to tie that off. So we get a nice, firm chicken. Trim that off. Nice firm chicken, ready to roast. All nice and tidy. It's one unit now, so it roasts as one piece instead of actually being legs hanging off and so on. So that's a chicken using a trussing needle.